challenge along the way. With courage I will face. I will paddle every day to claim my rightful place. Come with me, the tide is high. There's no better team. Arm in arm, we'll win the fight. It's always been a dream.
Pokemon, gotta catch a bug. I
know it's my destiny.
Hope you all enjoyed that. That was Subject to Change, my a cappella group singing the Pokemon theme. And if you all didn't notice, I was the one singing the solo in the second verse in the low part. If you all did enjoy, just let me know and I'll have some more clips for you all to listen to. Anyways, on to this match. It's a rematch that I had with Johnny Gengar. This was OU this time. I didn't have that many OU pokes, so I just kind of brought some lousy things. Turns out he brought a rain team that I thought that my Ampharos would be awesome against, but he gets the freeze hacks against it early after my Ferrothorn set up some entry hazards. And then he gets the confusion hacks with Hurricane, so even if I did manage to somehow break out of the freeze chance, I would then have to break out of the confusion chance, and then my electric type versus his rain team goes down without doing a darn thing. So I'm basically down 5-6 from the start of the match. Ampharos didn't get to do anything. Fortunately, though, I am able to bring in Senor, the Ludicolo, and knock out that Tornadus. He brings in Jirachi. I was actually fearing it to be especially defensive, and so I actually probably could have 2-hit KO'd it with Thunder. I mean, wow, that's the move he used, with Hydro Pump, assuming both of them hit. I bring in Ferrothorn, hoping that he has HP Fire, and it looks like he does based on the damage that it did, because HP Fighting would have done more, because the rain wouldn't have been up. So I'm guessing that that's HP Fire, and I just paralyze him, just because I know that'll make him easier to deal with later on. He gets a crit on the second one. Based on the damage he did on the first one, he probably would not have knocked me out, giving me a chance to set up some more entry hazards. But that's okay. I'm just going to come in here, and you see how much that does. Min max damage, maybe it would have mattered there, but I would have loved it if he hadn't gotten off all the extra damage on my Ludicolo. But that's okay, because I can just finish him off with the Giga Drain. And I don't have to worry about Jirachi anymore. I really don't like Jirachi. I have a plush of it from the Pokemon Center in Japan that I got at a convention. That is the extent of my liking for Jirachi, and that's only because the plushie is soft and cuddly. And it still has the tags on it, because you got to keep the tags. Anyways, though, he goes out in the Ferrothorn. I'm expecting him to just set up some entry hazards, and so I went out into my Cloyster so that I could get it in before it takes too much entry hazard damage. I just go for the Shell Smash because I know I can mortally wound any Ferrothorn that's not carrying Thunder Wave. And seeing that he had Gyro Ball, I was thinking that he didn't have Thunder Wave, because if you're using Gyro Ball and you use Thunder Wave together with it, typically that doesn't make sense because you're going to lower the power of your own Gyro Ball. He brings out Politoed. I was thinking maybe I can take this thing out right now, and I actually do with 2 critical hits, which it actually didn't matter because he swapped it in on the Rock Blast, so I could have just gone for another Rock Blast and taken it out, so those crits didn't matter. He brings in Vaporeon here, and I was tempted to just go for Explosion because I didn't want to deal with any Wish Protect shenanigan bullcrap from that thing. But it turns out he just goes for Roar, so maybe I should have exploded on it because he roars me out into my Cresselia. And this is a weird Cresselia. I caught it back in on my Pearl version, and it was a modest nature, and I wasn't really sure what to do with it, because of course it doesn't have a good hidden power, and so I've just been trying out different sets on it, really. And he actually goes for the Toxic on the switch, which again really sucks. I was expecting him to Protect, that's why I switched out right there, because he went for Wish. But if that was a prediction, that was a very good prediction, because he didn't have any reason to use a water move, really, unless he wanted to go for the burn. And Cresselia is good to get the Toxic on because it's so bulky. So here I just go for the safe Giga Drain, wanting to get some of that HP back. I wasn't really sure what his Ferrothorn wanted to do to me. I know I'm blazing fast because of the rain. And I didn't really want to get hit by a Gyro Ball because that would definitely kill me at 37 health. And so I go ahead and swap out, and he predicts that, and he paralyzes me. That's a little bit unfortunate because now I can't outspeed everything on his team. I dodge the Leech Seed, which doesn't really matter in this sense because I'm not going to be able to take out Ferrothorn in one hit anyway. And I have a good chance of getting paralyzed to make up for it, you know, 25% chance. So that's not too big of a deal yet. He's actually going to swap out again, go out into Vaporeon. And I was really close to predicting that, but I didn't want to give him a chance to set up a Leech Seed for free. If he was going to set up a Leech Seed, I wanted to take him down to half health at least. And so he's under 50%. Now he's at 50% after leftovers. He goes for Wish. I'm like, please don't get paralyzed. Please. And I get paralyzed. So that is payback for the Leech Seed miss that we had right there, allowing him to get back the HP that he would have likely gotten back from having Leech Seed. Now after the Shell Smash defense, special defense drop, and the Rain Stab boost of Surf, it's still not enough to take me out. And I'm just praying that this is enough to finish him off before he wishes up again. And fortunately it is. Unfortunately, I forgot that the light screen was up. That's the only reason I took that Surf. But unfortunately, he brings out Gyarados, which, if I weren't paralyzed, I could have just exploded on it. Because I would not have counted on Rock Blast to hit, really, knowing my luck. Or knowing luck in general, because Pokemon luck goes both ways. But now I go, maybe I can just paralyze him with Cresselia, because I still have a few Pokemon left. But as I see him substitute up, I know that this is a sub DD Dragonite, and it just so happens that I just took Charge Beam off my Cresselia, because I have been playing around with movesets for it and EVs for it, and I don't really know what to do with this thing, because it's not really good at anything because of its weird IV spread and its modest nature. But good legit legendaries are kind of hard to get, unless you're doing RNG, and I hadn't learned how to RNG back when Diamond, Pearl, Platinum. I didn't learn it until Heart Gold, Soul Silver. And then they changed it in Black and White, and I haven't bothered to learn it again. Anyways, though, I see that it takes two Psychics to break his sub, which sucks, because that means he can just sweep me, because I don't have anything I can swap in, and I can't. He has no reason to not just keep subbing, so there's no way for me to paralyze him. So at this point, it's going to be good game. I think he gets up to plus 4, plus 5, somewhere in there. He sets up a lot, and I kind of think at a certain point it was a little bit unnecessary to set up that much, but I guess he just wanted to be really, really sure. With rain-boosted waterfalls, I don't really see the point of setting up quite that much. I don't know. You all can let me know what you think. I guess it's good to ensure victory at that point. But anyways, though, I did enjoy the match. I need to stop bringing such a random mix of Pokemon to OU battles. I found that in lower tiers, maybe UU and under, I can bring a random mix of Pokemon and still do okay just by my experience in the game. But OU, often Pokemon find themselves outclassed in OU, and bringing a random mix often isn't as good of an idea. I'd be interested to hear what you all think about that. Surely a decent amount of creativity has place, but if you want to win the match, you should probably bring things that are a little bit more useful. But anyways, though, he finally goes for the waterfall to knock out my Cresselia. I have Choice Scarf Latios left, but after all those speed boosts, it is not going to outspeed it. And that waterfall is so powerful that it takes out Latios, even though he resists it. And the rain's not helping either. Senor, even with the Swift Swim, is not going to outspeed it. And I quad resist the waterfall, and at 37 HP, I'm not going to live that. So I lose this match. I need to have one more rematch with him just so we can have a 2 out of 3 type thing going. But I did enjoy it, even though I basically got swept at the end there. But had I taken out the Gyarados or managed to get it paralyzed, the only thing he had left was his Ferrothorn, I believe, if I remember correctly. But I did enjoy the match. So if you all enjoyed the Pokemon bit at the beginning, let me know, and I'll try to get better quality audio of that. That was me recording it with my iPhone. And I hope you all have a great week. Be sure to check out my Pokemon blog and let me know who you think you want to know more about. I recently did one on Porygon, and I found myself at about 1,000 words, and I hadn't even started on Porygon 2 or Porygon Z. So I'd be interested to hear who you all want to know more about. I got some requests for Weezing, a request for Psyduck, so just let me know. I hope you all have a great day, and I will talk to you all later. Bye now.